Hi church family, Jason and
Aimee here.
We are something like 6 weeks into the lockdown restrictions. What an experience this has been.
I must say that my initial thoughts went something along the lines of, oh boy, this is going to be interesting. For those of you who don't know us, we have three wonderful boys who can also be wonderfully noisy and energetic, as you can see there. How on earth were we going to manage being confined to home all the time, together, all the time? Add to that the juggle of our work lives. And quite honestly, there have been some tense, hair-pulling moments. It hasn't always been easy, but there's also been many fun memories made. We've had some crazy fun times that hopefully our boys will look back on fondly.
We hope that for many of you, the halt on our busy lives has been an opportunity to reset, enjoy some quality time with family, and create memories together. But for many in our church and wider community, it has been a stressful, lonely, and worrying time.
For me, working in the healthcare system, there was a lot of uncertainty and perhaps fear in the early days of lockdown as people anticipated what we might encounter. I was reminded daily, though, of God's promises. Psalm 46, verse 1 to 3, God is our refuge and strength and ever-present help in trouble. Therefore we will not fear, though the earth give way and the mountains fall into the heart of the sea, though its waters roar and foam and the mountains quake with their surging. Deuteronomy 31 verse 8, it is the Lord who goes before you. He will be with you. He will not fail you or forsake you. Do not fear or be dismayed. We hope that those verses will bring some comfort to those struggling through this period.
One thing we've been challenged by over the past weeks is how best we can help others, that God is able to open our eyes to see need, whether that be within family circles, friends, neighbours, work colleagues, or even people not known to us. And we've been prompted to respond in a number of different ways, sometimes with just simple things like sending messages of support or delivering baking, but we can also see that there are people currently experiencing real financial hardship.
We have an awesome opportunity now and in the months ahead to respond as a church family to the huge need that will be facing many. How cool would it be if those who are hurting financially, socially, mentally, whatever the need, if people could unashamedly come forward and we as a church family pull together to meet their needs. I know so many are already doing so much. Let's just continue to show God's love to others in these very practical ways.